Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh.
Good morning students. In this section, you are going to learn about nutrition in plants. Children, already we discussed that all living organisms such as plants and animals require food. So, food is essential for all living organisms. Plants are capable of making their own food themselves, but humans and animals cannot. Now, let us discuss the mode of nutrition in plants. Plants prepare their own food by using raw material like water, carbon dioxide and minerals. The process of utilizing of food by a living organism to obtain energy is called nutrition. Let us discuss the importance of nutrients. Children, organisms need food to obtain energy, to obtain materials for growth, to obtain materials for repair of damaged body parts and to carry out life process. Methods of nutrition takes place in two different types. One is autotrophs and second one is heterotrophs. Now let us discuss in detail about autotrophs or autotrophic nutrition. Plants that have chlorophyll trap the energy from the sunlight and prepare their own food. Such nutrition, wherein the food is prepared by the organism itself, is called autotrophic nutrition. The organisms capable of preparing their own food are called autotrophs. All green plants are autotrophs. Auto means self and trophs means nourishment. They prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Now let us discuss about heterotrophs or heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic organisms are those who obtain food from other organisms. Since these organisms depend on other organisms for their food, they are called consumers. All animals and non-green plants like fungi comes under this category. Organisms that follow the heterotrophic mode of nutrition are called heterotrophs. Now, let us discuss about photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means the process by which green plants make their own food from water and carbon dioxide in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll is called as photosynthesis. Let us study in detail the process of photosynthesis. The process of photosynthesis takes place in the green leaves of a plant. The food is prepared by the green leaves of a plant in the form of a simple sugar called glucose. The extra glucose is changed into another food called starch. This starch is stored in the leaves of the plant. The green plants converted sunlight energy into chemical energy by making carbohydrates. Now, let us discuss the steps which are involved in the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis mainly involved in three steps and these are: first one, absorption of sunlight energy by chlorophyll; second one, conversion of light energy into chemical energy and splitting of water into hydrogen and oxygen by light energy; third one, reduction of carbon dioxide by hydrogen to form carbohydrate like glucose by utilizing the chemical energy. Conditions necessary for photosynthesis. The conditions necessary for the photosynthesis to take place are sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide and water. Raw material for photosynthesis. The raw material for photosynthesis are carbon dioxide and water. Now, let us discuss about how do the plants obtain carbon dioxide. Children, there are a large number of tiny pores called stomata on the surface of the leaves of a plant. The carbon dioxide gas enters the leaves of a plant through the stomata present on their surface. Each stomatal pore is surrounded by a pair of guard cells. The opening and closing of stomatal pores is controlled by the guard cells. Now, let us discuss about how the plants obtain water for the photosynthesis. The water required by the plants for photosynthesis is absorbed by the roots of the plants from the soil through the process of osmosis. The water absorbed by the roots of the plant is transported upwards to the xylem vessel to the leaves where it is reached the photosynthetic cells. Plants also need other raw materials such as nitrogen, phosphorus, iron and magnesium for building their body. The plants take these materials from the soil. Nitrogen is an essential element used by the plants to make the proteins and other compounds. Let us discuss about the chloroplasts. Photosynthesis takes place in the leaves of the plant. Leaves have green color pigment called chlorophyll. It helps leaves to capture the energy of the sunlight, which is then used to prepare the food from carbon dioxide and water. Solar energy is captured by the leaves and it is stored in the plants in the form of food. So we can say that sun is ultimate source of energy for all living organisms. Children, points to be remembered in this lesson are: all living organisms such as plants and animals require food. Food is a nutritive substance taken by an organism for the growth, repair and maintaining the life process. Photosynthesis in plants can also take place in other green parts like green stems and green branches. Glucose is the simplest food synthesized by the plants. This glucose made by the plants is converted into complex carbohydrates which are known as starch. These simple carbohydrates are used to synthesize other components of food such as proteins and fats. Proteins are nitrogenous substances. Plants prepare proteins with the help of nitrogen which is obtained from the soil. Plants use the minerals dissolved in water to convert glucose into carbohydrates and fats. Photosynthesis is important because it provides food to animals including human beings. It puts oxygen gas into the air, which is essential for breathing and respiration in animals and human beings. Thank you.